heard on us. You have somebody testify about that, and then you'll have a panel to educate us further. We will pick from Cecilia's lesson. We'll be telling you very soon. I was tempted to ask, like Jesus asked, when he fed people and he asked the disciples, cross over the sea, we meet the other side. And before Jesus was there, the multitude was already there asking, where is our master? We want to hear more. And Jesus asked them, he asked them, are you sure you are looking for me because you want? Or it's because of the food that? So I'm sure, I know there are those who have genuinely come for chapel, and there are those who think we are continuing, no? But we will continue. We are requesting another day so that you can complete that. She did tell you the psychological effect of cashew sets and also emotional, spiritual, because as you sleep with a person, you form soul ties. And that carries you all the way your life. Even when you get married, you'll be putting your husband or your wife in a competition that they are not aware of. You just be asking, why is this man not doing like, you know? But you cannot open your mouth because they will tell you, oh, you never told me about this, right? So we will take you through that. And again, when you enroll for that course, we will teach you more in details, right? Thank you. So can we have giving us a testimony as we continue?
Praise God again. Those who don't know the feeling of standing here, you can come after this, I will not support you. Because I am feeling it right now. I'm Avishi Jovian, a counseling psychology student, second year. Yeah, I'm in second year. Yeah, so I'm sharing my experience in counseling psychology. And I didn't really know about counseling psychology. I had never even heard about it. So after high school, I was 17. Yeah, I know that age. You are the only one who is right and the only one who is right. So I was ruled, I was everything. And my parents were having that hard time. You know, you look at this kid, you've raised them in a church way, but you wonder what is happening. And so this day, my aunt suggests that I join a counseling psychology. I go and do a certificate in counseling psychology. And I face her head on, and I tell her, I'm doing it for you. And I was very comfortable. And she said, yeah, you are doing it for me as you join that institution. By the time you are getting out, you know you are doing it for yourself. So I was like, and I will make sure I prove I'm doing it for you. So I joined this institution. It's called Kenya Association of Professional Counselors in Parklands. And when I enter in class the first day, these people are way older than me. I'm looking at them and I'm like, what? And as we're introducing ourselves, there's a businessman, there's a lawyer, there's a nurse, there's an Indian lady whose account, when we were sharing, when it's at 500,000, she's broke. And I'm there, when I have 5 bob, I'm doing fine. And you know the way you look at someone, observing them, microscopic eyes, she's saying, and she's even crying, and you know I'm zooming in, these are microscopic eyes, now I'm zooming in. Yeah. You said five what? And yeah. So we were sharing, and we did a lot of tasks during that time. And one of the tasks was to write about our likes and dislikes. And you know me, and you write a quote that motivates you. And me, I was there with a quote. My quote was, I care less. When you force me to care, I care carelessly. And then one of my likes was, I like laughing. I have this sense of humor. I can laugh playing a funeral, and it was true. People are crying and are busy looking for something to laugh. So we are like, and then I'm like, you know, and people are like, you know, and someone is closing my mouth, but I don't see, I didn't feel anything bad about it. I thought I was being myself. And again, my dislike was, I don't like when people don't like when I laugh. I'm laughing and people are busy telling me I'm doing the wrong thing. But when we were sharing, I discovered one thing, that I was in pain because I grew up, and I grew up in pain because of betrayal. Like, for example, my dad would leave, just walk out one day and say he's going to work. And he would walk out and he would stay 2 years. No one knows where he is. And when he comes back, life has to go back like nothing happened. And I'm a young girl here wondering, I want an explanation. Why is he? I wanted him to say even sorry, you know. But he never said it. And that pained me. And even in high school when I was there, I would only say sorry. Not because I am sorry, because I wasn't sorry. But I was looking at you like I can smash you. My friend, I will pass it through. I will destroy your bones. That's why I would say sorry. But again, when I was sharing, I realized the reason why I laughed, even in funerals, is because other people are in pain like me. And I was using their pain to make them even feel worse. That's why I would laugh. Today I laugh not because someone is in pain. Another thing I realized, that I hurt people's emotions. But I'm not the only one who is important. Other people are. And as I venture into counseling even more in AIU, I realized that there are things I can't solve. I don't have to wait for you to tell me sorry. I can do it on your behalf. And after sharing, there was this one thing I realized, that I had peace. For the first time, I was not carrying anyone in my heart. For the first time, I was very calm. For the first time, I felt content. There was that, yani, and I don't know how many people have experienced that, you know, but that's what I felt. And that's why I'm doing psychology today. And as I wind up, I would want to say that you are very much privileged to have a counseling center here. You don't have to have a lot in you. Even studying here is stressful. Walk in, talk to someone and then walk out. You'll realize a difference. By the time you're walking out, you'll feel content. You'll feel at peace. You can even now think. And you know, maybe you are just stressed that you had a term paper of 5 pages. But you know, it was stressful. And as you are sharing, these are businessmen, an Indian lady, and everyone. And I learned that people have problems. That even 500,000 shillings can make someone cry. And someone else with 5 bob like me or nothing. We are just fine. So what is a problem to you may not be a problem to someone else, but it's hard for them. If you can help them, cope up, tell them, talk to them, be someone's keeper, let them share with you what they are going through. That's why we are counselors here, we are your friends. Come to me, tell me, oh, we think together. You have 100 shillings. And I wonder how, you know, for girls, we go and we have issues. And even guys, you are smartly dressed, you are served at cafeteria, and there's this bone with meat. And you can't at you, they will see me, my friend, eat all the meat there. And that is what I'll tell you, that's the motivation I want you to have as working in the counseling center. Walk in, go talk, open up, be free. Because there's confidentiality, you never hear that story outside. There's confidentiality, they are ashamed. Have a nice day.